Hi, it's Marietta, founder of Immigration Biz and Business Immigration Attorney. And in this video, I'm going to talk about E2 versus H1B visa. Particularly, I'm going to talk about self-sponsoring. So if you want to run your own business, which option is for you? So let's start. E2 visa is definitely for business owners and entrepreneurs and people who want to run their own businesses in the US. However, you need to establish that you have invested substantial amount of capital. So the term substantial is in fact sort of relative because it really depends on the kind of business you are starting in the US or buying, whether you're buying existing business or you're starting totally new business from scratch. It really depends, but in general, it can be anywhere from 50 to 500,000 US dollars. Obviously with H1B work visa, this is a different story because you don't need to establish any kind of substantial amount of capital. But if you are sponsoring yourself, you need to show that you have started your own business and you are in fact self-petitioned yourself. So it's a totally different story. You have to really show that there is no direct managing and control between you and the company. So there's gotta be some sort of board of directors or maybe a different organization structure. So you can show that even though you founded the business, there are other managers, other people who control the business, and you will be probably maybe employed in a capacity of a manager and so on. So there has to be a distinguishing factor between the entity and yourself. On the other hand, with E2 visa, you are the one who needs to be in control and manage the business. This is actually one of the requirements, and you need to show that the funds that you have invested are actually your funds and you as an investor are taking and bearing a risk. Now, this might sound a little bit scary, but in fact, in reality, it's not that difficult. Also with H1B work visa, the problem is that there is a limit, right? And this limit is only up to 85,000 visas per year. So if more applicants apply for this visa, what is going to happen? There is going to be a lottery. And lottery means random selections of the applicants. So you in fact have no guarantee to receive this visa. Therefore, I strongly suggest to go with E2 visa if you do qualify, if you are from a treaty country, because not everyone is qualified. If you are not from a treaty country, you can consider alternatively L visa. If you don't have a business in your home country, you can start business in your home country, incorporate, so you do have an entity running a business in your country. You are the one who is employed by the entity in your home country, and later on you can come to the US and establish affiliated office. This would be under category L1A. Majority of multinational companies are applying for this visa type because it's easier than H1B work visa. So H1B versus E2. Yes, H1B is for people who actually have a sponsor. It's more suitable for people who have US sponsor in the US. If you don't have a US sponsor in the US, you can found the company yourself, but a company must be on the market at least 1 year, and I would really recommend if it's even longer, because you need to show that this company is active, you know, you need to show that it's really generating profit and is able to pay you a salary. Because as you know, part of the application when you apply for H1B is actually LCA. So you need to be approved by the Department of Labor. You need to get your LCA and you need to show that this company itself is able to pay you the salary. And tell you the truth, it really depends. I mean, obviously, what is your position? But when it comes to lawyers, you know, accountants, and other professionals, these salaries are pretty high. So you will have the pressure. There is going to be definitely pressure. So you need to establish that this company will be able to pay you this salary. And that is based on the numbers, based on the previous year, and based on the tax returns, based on the P&L and other documentation that you need to put together. So if you're just starting out, but if you do have some capital ready, I recommend to go with E2, because like I said, you don't need to invest half a million. You can go with 50,000. You know, I had a client who invested 50,000, 70,000, 100,000, and they got E2 visa. So it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to invest half a million if you want to get E2. So if you're just starting out, it's better to apply for E2, and you don't have to go through the struggle of H1B. Now, what to do next, right? Because obviously the visa is just a temporary solution. For some might be a long-term solution because E2 allows you to actually run a business. Some countries have a treaty with the US in such a way that you can actually run a business for couple of years. In fact, you know, you can keep E2 indefinitely. There is a unlimited renewal option for you. But there are some countries that doesn't allow this. For example, Iran. You know, if you are from Iran, and by the way, Iran, it's another story when it comes to the travel ban and the other restrictions, right? But in general, like, there are countries that allows you to apply for E2 visa only for 3 months, you know, or allows you to renew it for only maybe even one time, so you cannot renew it multiple times, right? Like, for example, Czech Republic, you can renew, or Australia, you can renew multiple times. So it really comes down to the international treaty between your country and the US. Therefore, you have to check what are the particular requirements for your country and, you know, consider these options. Again, like, if you're not from a treaty country, maybe you want to consider L visa, because this way there is no limit. Keep in mind that with H1B work visa, there is a limit, okay? And you don't want to go through the struggle of applying, paying the fees, and then you won't be selected in a lottery. All right, so this is it, guys. If you have any questions, leave them below this video and check out my free training on how you can actually apply for E2 visa and live your American dream. You can sign up for the free training below. And if you do like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to my weekly update. Thank you so much for watching.